My name is Karen Nuytemans. I'm a scientist. I work as an assistant scientist here at the John Hussman Institute for Human Genomics. Specifically, I work on the genetic causes of Parkinson's disease. So we're trying to identify different genetic factors that might be involved in the Parkinson's disease pathogenesis. I'm originally from Belgium. I finished both my master's and my PhD at the University of Antwerp. I'm 30 years old now. I think it's relatively young for somebody as an assistant scientist. How did I end up in genetics? I didn't really have a clear idea early on that I wanted to do genetics per se. And at the end of my high school, I basically had to pick what I wanted to do in college. And this might not be the best way of picking your major or minor. I basically picked whatever I liked to do the most, and that was chemistry at that point. I don't know, I've always been intrigued by puzzles and trying to make everything work and see how this and this would add up together. So I went to go to college and do chemistry. At some point it started to get quite theoretical with theoretical quantum physics and a lot more physics than I personally cared for. And I was trying to get back to that interesting genetics part that I got in high school. I wanted to go back to more biology side of chemistry, so that's when I went into biochemistry, and that's how a lot of genetics was introduced to me, and that really interests me again, also because it's more of a puzzle, like, okay, how do these different alleles together cause disease? So that's how I ended up on that path. Compartments of biochemistry has different classes, so for me it was all very structured and it all made sense, and it was all super interesting, like how your body works and how everything all together with chemistry, biology and chemistry together, how you function. Basically, and genetics was one of the parts of that. It's the background idea that once I determine what might cause a disease and what's the background of it, we might be able to find a therapy that might actually help people and not be as sick or the disease progresses less fast. Yeah, that's, I think, why a lot of people are in genetics of complex diseases or diseases that are more common or even rare diseases.